Bonjour madame, merci d'être avec nous. Je sais que vous parlez français, mais on va vous allez me répondre en anglais ou en français si vous voulez. Venez, venez vous installer si vous voulez. On va parler un peu de l'industrie sud-africaine, if you don't mind, ok? Alors, vous avez été, vous êtes représentante en France du ministère de l'Industrie et du Commerce. Et puis, on va faire un peu focus sur l'industrie sud-africaine que vous connaissez particulièrement bien. Et puis, vous avez été aussi en charge du National Empowerment Fund. On parlera aussi de la question du Black Empowerment en Afrique du Sud. Alors, je vais vous poser ma question en français, if you don't mind, my question in French. Alors, que voulez-vous dire? Quelle est la stratégie aujourd'hui de l'Afrique du Sud to upgrade, pour monter en gamme, l'industrie sud-africaine, qui est la plus puissante de très très loin du continent. Attention, c'est une industrie puissante. Ça fait 13% de leur PIB. Ils produisent plus de 500 000 voitures, 500 000 cars a year en Afrique du Sud. Mais ils ont eu des problèmes un peu de productivité et comment intégrer plus l'industrie sud-africaine dans les chaînes de valeur mondiales, in worldwide supply chain. Que voulez-vous faire passer? What do you want to tell us about South African industry and the future of it? How to upgrade the South African industry? Alors, là aussi, alors celui-ci aussi.
Merci, monsieur. Bonjour et à tous les PDG de grandes sociétés ici en France et les sociétés en Afrique du Sud. Et merci à Business France pour l'invitation. Et merci beaucoup, monsieur. Alors, juste pour vous dire que j'étais PDG d'une société qui s'appelle le National Empowerment Fund en Afrique du Sud. C'était jusqu'à décembre l'année dernière et cette année. Quand mon mari a été nommé comme ambassadeur de France, alors d'Afrique du Sud, ici en France. Merci. Moi, je me suis dit que je ne vais pas rater cette occasion. Alors, c'est pour ça que je suis ici.
Eh bien, merci.
Voilà. Alors, monsieur, je vais vous donner quelques statistiques at a high level avant de répondre à votre question. South Africa has one of the most developed, diversified, and technologically advanced economies on the African continent. It is the second largest economy in Africa and 21st in the world. That is according to the 23 markets exchange rates. South Africa has a well-developed industrial ecosystem and highly diversified economy, and I will talk about that later, particularly its established manufacturing sector and the different value chains. The country's physical infrastructure and extensive transport and logistics network, even though we are experiencing a few challenges with our logistics at the moment, is strongly integrated with other Southern African countries. Other comparative advantages include its supportive operating environment. So the largest sectors contributing to GDP are finance, real estate, business services at 23%, personal services at 16%, and the manufacturing sector at 14.4%. What this says is that we are slowly migrating away from the commodities. Because you'll remember that 20 years ago, the commodities in South Africa, especially the mining sector, were sitting at around 30%. So we're slowly moving away from those particular sectors. And then when it comes to the exports, we have one of the most open economies in the world, and our exports and imports of goods and services represent about 65.7%. European markets account for 18.4%, and France, which is another topic for discussion today, only accounts for 0.5 percent of our total exports. So we should be talking about how we're going to expand on the work that we're already doing. So how do we move from 0.5% maybe to 1%,
uh-huh, right,
for a start? That should be our
target. So how to upgrade once again the industry and to make it more and more competitive?
So we have now, so I'm here to represent both the DTIC and the IDC because I'm the non-executive director of the IDC. IDC en Afrique du Sud, c'est à peu près comme l'Agence française du développement, mm-hmm, ici en France. So our mandate is to drive the industrialization of the economy by creating jobs for the South African market. So the new pathways that we have actually developed for ourselves. So our approach and the strategic positioning as the IDC is that we have realized that a sustainable industrialization model should actually go beyond the mitigation of harm and should focus on creating long-run inclusive growth and employment through low carbon transitions. So it means in all our new investments, we're now looking at how we can actually achieve the just transition from high carbon intensive industries to the low carbon, uh-huh, transitions. So that is our first priority as the IDC. So we're also seeking to leverage Southern Africa's abundant renewable energy and critical minerals to foster international competitiveness of industry in the region. And we also realize that the success of sustainable industrialization relies on the collective ecosystem development to actually maximize shared benefits. So I will just share a few examples of the work that we are now doing. So the first one relates to the catalyzation of low carbon transition and green growth, whereby the IDC is supporting firms to adapt and innovate cleaner technologies, fuels and processes in the transition to higher productivity sectors like manufacturing, including supporting existing hard to abate sectors to transition, like your chemicals and your steel and your steel industry.
Eh bien, parfait. Merci, madame. Alors, la deuxième question que je pourrais avoir, je vous la pose à celle qui a été l'ancienne CEO du National Empowerment Fund. Pouvez-vous nous donner votre vision de la mise en place, enfin, de l'efficacité, efficiency, aujourd'hui, du South African Empowerment Policy? Est-ce qu'il y a des choses à modifier aujourd'hui dans cette politique d'empowerment or not?
Okay, maybe, merci. So just quickly to say that the National Empowerment Fund is the only entity in South Africa that was set up to drive, a transformation in the country. So I don't have to talk about our history. So the South African government realized that there was a need to actually involve the participation of black-owned companies in the South African economy. So when I say black-owned, I mean 51% and above. So we still encourage partnerships between black-owned companies and the white-owned businesses, whether they are South African or from elsewhere. So the model that we used, which is the model that has been adopted by the South African government, was to say that, make an observation that if you are looking at black-owned companies in the country, you know, at the time when we were establishing the NEF, a lot of black-owned enterprises were still in the periphery of the economy. So they were just involved in your services related, you know, sectors of the country. So we took a decision as the NEF that we wanted to drive black industrialization By that, we meant we wanted to see more involvement of black-owned companies in some of the key sectors of the economy. It would be in your pharmaceutical industry, it would be in your private healthcare, it would be in chemicals, plastics, agro-processing, and. So, but also if you look at the previous model of, or the first phase of black economic empowerment in South Africa, it was just based on share ownership. So you'd find a lot of partners who would come in maybe to acquire 5 or 10% of an established company. So we wanted to move beyond that. So by that, we meant we wanted to establish companies that will be managed, operated, and actually run by black executives or by black entrepreneurs. So if you look at the companies, we supported more than 1,600 and something plus companies in South Africa who had partnerships with both the local South African companies and international investors. We have invested close to 13.4 billion rands from our own balance sheet. But if you look at the third party or off balance sheet activities, it would be an additional 15 billion rands. So a lot of those companies are looking at real partnerships with foreign partners, and they are now moving beyond the share ownership. We're talking about men and women who wake up every morning to actually, go and run those companies, as opposed to just being passive investors in the different, companies that they were involved in the past. So that has now led to the creation of this new policy that is driven by the DTIC that is referred to as the Black Industrialization Program. You may have actually heard about that program. So what it does is that if you come with a concept as a French-owned business, let's say you have a feasibility study that you are already working on and you are looking for black partners, you can either partner with the National Empowerment or the DTIC, because the DTIC has now allocated funds just for the implementation of the Black Industrialization Program. In fact, it's the IDC, NEF, and the DTIC that are actually driving those particular initiatives. The case in point, which is a very interesting example, I have to talk about this one, is the investment that was done by Stellantis. So it's a partnership between Peugeot and another American company. It's a 3 billion rand investment. Is going to be in Kuha. Mm-hmm. It was funded by both the French banks and the IDC. The IDC has invested more than 1 billion rands, and we're going to create more than 1,000 jobs during construction and during operations. So it's a very, very exciting project, and it involves some black entrepreneurs as well. So that's what I wanted to emphasize.
Exactement. Thank you very much. Oui, c'est un investissement de 150 millions d'euros à peu près pour faire 80 000 voitures, avec peut-être à terme des voitures électrifiées, électriques, et évidemment dont a besoin aussi l'Afrique du Sud. Merci beaucoup, madame. Thank you very much. Merci, madame. Madame, mettez-toi d'avoir été en notre compagnie pour nous parler de l'industrie sud-africaine, les investissements, et puis la dimension du Black Empowerment. Merci à vous.